The core is, like I had said earlier, it's the strength with which we build our entire organization on. Because you haven't heard me talk about work ethic, about focus, about discipline. Those are all the parts of our core. And I'm going to give you a couple things. Number one, work ethic. Number one, work ethic. That's an ingredient of our core. And what we say about work ethic is we want you to work on the days you don't feel like it. I'm just going to give you one little bullet on each of our core principles. Our core. Focus, another core ingredient. And core, C-O-R-E, another ingredient. And with focus, we simply say, allow me to get a drink of water here. We simply say, have complete and utter attention to detail. That's what focus is to us. Another ingredient of our core, discipline. And this is where all of these types of things you can put into your own non-X and O, your own champion's DNA. And with discipline, we simply say this. Discipline yourself to be disciplined. I know it's, you know, there's so many definitions of it. Character. And again, I had to go in and out because we're running the event here, so I had to check on some things today. I didn't hear every bit of Doc's thing, but if he didn't say this, he always says it to our team. We want character, not characters. Because I don't know if you really caught it, but what Doc did when someone asked him about defining roles, he actually does a couple times a year, look straight in the guy's eyes and says, this is your role. And he does it. The hand gesture that he had when he was saying it, that's what he does on our practice floor. Because as he said, he wants not only that player to know, but he wants every other player to know and every coach. Because I guarantee you, sometimes the head coach you work for, he knows the roles of the players, but he forgot to tell you. Okay? All right? So another core, commitment. Here's what we say to commitment. It has no expiration date. Commitment has no expiration date. You can't be committed on Tuesday, not on Thursday. You can't be, we have a thing we call 100% in too. And I'll just give you one thing that you can let it fly when you put your pen to the paper tonight. But we say 100% in. What do we mean? In being a teammate, 100% in. You're not a teammate on Tuesday, not on Thursday. It's 100% in. In loyalty, you can't be 64% loyal. That's bullshit. That's not the word that the L word. If you're only 64% loyal, the real L word there is loser, loser, loser. And the other L would probably be, let's get his ass out of here. Okay? All right. Buy-in. That's the 100% in I was just talking about. I'm going to have to read this one because, again, this is my summer project, trying to put all this together, not just for you. It's turned into something for us, too. Another one is sacrifice. And what we are going to say to our guys, that success is a choice. Reaching it isn't a choice, but going after it is a choice. The choice is, are you going to go after it? The choice is, are you going to go after it? And what we're going to say to our guys is, the price is what you have to pay to get there. The choice is, are you going to go after it? The price is what you have to pay to get there. Are you willing to do that? Are you willing to do that? Because we've got a tough road to hoe, man. There's some good teams happening south of us, not just in Florida. There's some good teams starting to form in New York, Philly, Washington's changing. You know, there's some good teams forming right now. The other core, and then I'll move on to something else, is resolve. Resolve. And this is the ability to just come back and do it again. And resolve is a big word with our defense. We think it's one of the most important words we use with our defense. And Doc will say it in the huddle. We're losing our resolve. And resolve is this. Let's use Miami. Let's say Ray is guarding Dwayne. Dwayne comes down, hits a jumper right in Ray's face. Ray has to come back the next possession, get down in the stance, and practice it the exact same way he did in practice the other 64 practices we had. Now Dwayne comes down, crosses him over, drives to the lane. Ray has to come back down the very next possession, show defensive resolve, and get down in his stance and force it to where we want to force it, have your feet where we want you to have your feet, and do it again. And then Dwayne comes down and dunks in Ray's face. He now has to come back, get down in his stance, and do it again. That is resolve. Resolve. Because good teams score points. But on the defensive end, good teams never give up or give in.